again. And, you know, this is really my privilege here to be sitting with him. He's really the king of the stage. And I get to question him today. So it's really a privilege for me to be joining him to...
I thought I would dress like an entrepreneur for you,
you
guys.
You actually dressed really well.
I look like low-budget Farhan Akhtar, no? It's... This is not going to be a sensible chat, guys. I just thought I'd prepare you. Or anyway, please, carry on. Yeah.
You just chose a business editor to do that sensible chat. But, you know, I think of all the things and great things that he's done, I think one thing that we should really give it to him is that he's made stand-up comedy a profession. So just give it on to him, guys, because, you know, anybody can just get up in the morning and say that I'm going to do a great act on the stage and not be able to repeat it day next and so on. But he's been doing it consistently, not just in India, but across the world, all those great acts, which has made him be with us today. So we're going to tell us about yourself. How did this journey start? When did you think startup comedy could actually be a great profession, a lifetime profession?
Well, I mean, that's a very kind introduction. I think what's very, my biggest achievement is that I've been able to do all of that without paying any taxes.
They don't tax you? Let me tell you that.
Did you know stand-up comedy is tax-free, guys? It's a tax-free job because it's zero income. And that's usually why it works out. 0% GST, 0% service tax because 100% grief, zero money. Sorry, what was the question? It was, how did I get into stand-up comedy?
Yeah, I mean, why did you and how did you think if this could be a profession or not just like an act?
I was drinking a lot. In college, no, when I came down to India, it was 2006, and I had studied abroad and I'd done some acting. And, you know, when I came down, there were three or four people who were doing stand-up comedy. You know, Baman Irani was doing stand-up comedy, and Bharat Dabolkar. And in Delhi, it was this very Arabia, South Delhi, Golf Links, India Habitat Center ka membership hai hamare paas. Aur hum mehne mein do baar jaate hain 500 rupaye ka ticket lekar stand up comedy dekhne ke liye, but there was nobody performing for kids, so that's why I felt like there was a big not like bachcha party, but you know,
college
kids. So there was nobody talking about, you know, girlfriends and boyfriends. Everybody was talking about bungalows and wives and husbands and jewelry, but nobody was talking about Delhi University, and that's where I sensed that there's an opening here for a young voice in stand up comedy. And stand up comedy is typically a young voice always.
So, you know, while you've done some work in Bollywood and probably some films, and you've done a great series on Netflix as well, but, you know, you've still sort of remained true to your profession, which is stand-up comedy, which is, again, what you do most. While I've realized, you know, you mentioned Boman Irani. Boman Irani's eventual goal was to be an actor. So is it something that, you know, that it sort of moves to or translates to eventually?
See, unless you are Salman Khan, you can't predict that your film is going to do well, right? So what I like is whether the film works or not on a Friday. To me, the one thing I learned from like Aamir Khan is that an artist is nothing more than a relationship with a fan base. Aamir comes once a year. He's like Alfonso. You know? So saal mein wo ek baar aata hai, lekin you wait for Alfonso season because Aamir ka picture aayega saal mein. And he has that relationship with the fans. And that's all it is. It's a long-standing relationship. And with an actor, the tough thing is, agar Friday ko film pit gayi, you have to wait 5 months to reinforce that relationship with the fans. With a comedian, you can be in a flop film on Friday and be on a hit on stage on Saturday and a hit on stage on Sunday. So why would you not take that opportunity to perform for that crowd? And also, you can age in the comedy profession. You know,
like being an actor.
Unlike being an actor, Jay Leno looked like shit on day one. And
she's not going to be too happy to hear that.
And now still does, but nobody cares because his brain is good. And that's what I like about this profession. You don't have to have a six-pack. You don't have to be, you know, young or fit or on TikTok. You can just be smart, I think.
Sure. But you're going to still, I mean, you don't have a GST to pay. So you can tell how much money do you make in this profession?
See, most of the shows that I do are for favors. No, I'm kidding. So, you know, it's now at a point where I think the real future of comedy in India is going to be regional comedy. And that's where the money is going to be. You know, who is the next big Punjabi comedian? Who is the next big Gujarati comedian? And what is their voice? And who are they talking about? And that's going to be where comedy will truly scale. When you have the courage that English comedians have, but you're able to do it in Punjabi and Gujarati and have that kind of freedom, I think that's when comedy will truly be global. So, yeah.
So how much preparation does it really take to do one stand-up comedy act and, you know, make it, as you know, Aditya said, you can have an excellent flight one day and then probably not so great in the next ones?
If you're writing it about the world, it takes a while. It takes 6 months. If you're writing it about home, which my new show is, it takes 3 months. Just because so much happens in India. You know, it moves so fast and you're just writing about, like Modi ji does something new every week that you can, you know, 1 week the currency is gone, 1 week it's something else. So there's constant fodder for what you can talk about as a comedian without going to jail, hopefully.
Let's hope he's not watching you.
No, he's not in the back. All right, that's great, huh?
So, you know...
By the way, when I said he's not in the back, five people looked at the back. They're like, Modi ji aa gaye. Chalo, Jai Shri Ram, Jai Shri Ram, everybody.